In this video, we are going to talk about Outlook rules. It's not a new feature, but I'm sure many of you already use Outlook rules. I'm going to show you best practices and common mistakes. So let's get started. What are rules? It's a simple kind of automation available within Outlook. So we have three things as a part of rules. There is a condition, there is an action, and there can be exceptions. So in simple terms, I say if when this happens, do that. The commonest rule which we create is what? I get a mail from someone and I put it in a folder with the name of that person. That is simple kind of automation using rules. Before we go ahead, if you're creating rules like that, don't do it. That's a bad idea. That's a very common mistake done. Because remember, when you apply rules, rules get applied automatically to the mail. Now, ideally, you should see the mail and then decide where to file it. If it goes automatically in separate folders, you will have to go to multiple folders to see new mails which have come up. Normally, we don't even have time to look at one inbox. Do you think you have time to look at 17 folders? No. So do not just auto-direct. It generally doesn't work well. Now, one more word of caution. Outlook rules work only within Outlook. But sometimes we want automation outside Outlook. So I get a mail, it has an attachment, it's a quotation from a vendor. I want to detach that file and put it on, say, OneDrive or Teams. Now, how do we do that? Well, you cannot do that using Outlook rules. For that, you have to use Power Automate. But that is a topic for another video. To understand rules, let's create a rule and then see how it works. Now, what is the scenario I'm going to talk about? In fact, even if you have created rules and if you have not created this rule, do it. It will be useful. Why? Because the rule I'm going to create will help me identify mails which are important to me. Now, mails can come from different people. They can have different subjects. So how do I create a rule which identifies mails which are important? It is not really looking at the text and the subject. It's just applying common sense. So when someone sends a mail to you, where is your name? Either in to or in CC? Or if you don't find it in either place, then it's in BCC, correct? Now, question is, how do I find out this particular mail is important to me? Depending on where my name is, can I think, is it important? So if it is in CC, not important. If it is in 2, important. But in 2 also, there are 5 other people. They're not important. But if I am the only person in the mail, that means there's only one person's name and that is in 2. That means it is important. By looking at the mail, I don't know where my name is. I'll have to double-click open, then I know whether I'm in 2CC. So this is what the rule can help us do. Now I'm going to create a new rule. So go to Inbox, Rules, and then create a new rule. New rules can be created on incoming mail as well as outgoing mail. Yes, there can be outbox rules also. Most of us create inbox rules. Okay, when a mail comes in. Now click Next. Now we have to specify the condition. Under what situation should this rule work? That's the trigger condition. It is going to look at every mail which is coming in, where it will wake up and do something only when the condition is met. Now look at all the conditions. Just read them once. You will get some ideas about where you can use it. Now, the one we are looking for is sent only to me. Yes, there is already a condition pre-created for that. Now, this is the condition. What is the action? So go to the next step. Now action is something you have to take. You have to read the mail and do whatever you need. Now all I need is when I'm looking at a long list of mails, this particular mail should be looking important. So something look and feel, color, I have to change. So in Outlook, we have color categories, right? At the bottom, you will see color categories sort of a hyperlink. Click on that. Now you choose what color you want to apply. So in my case, I've used a high priority red color. That's it. Now, next step is exceptions. Exceptions means what? This rule will be applied except under these circumstances. Right now, we don't have any exceptions. Move on. And then, okay. The rule is now turned on. Now, what does that mean? Upcoming mails, the mails which are going to come in future will be scanned by this rule. If I already have mails which have my name in the to box, that is not going to cover it because this is for future. But what if I want to run it on existing mails? Might as well do that. Sure. Now you go to the rules dialog, say run rules, choose the rule and let it run on existing mails. But be careful. Your mailbox may be large. Most people have thousands of mails there. So if you say run rule, it's going to actually run it on every mail you have. It may take time. It may sound as the Outlook is hanging, but no, it will work eventually. Now I'm going to send a mail from another mailbox to me where my name is only in the to box, and now let's see what happens. As soon as the mail comes, it is automatically flagged with red color. Now what do? I have some mails which are important and others are less important. How do I group them? Sure, right click on category and say group by category. Now we have two categories, important and less important. Now what if I want to have a medium priority category where my name is on the to box, but I'm not the only person? Okay, let's do that. You already know how to create a rule. So the condition I'm going to choose now is when my name is in the to box. Now remember, we have already created a rule which is looking at whether my name is the only name. Now in this case, I'm going to say if my name is in the to box, put a category, and I put yellow as medium category. Done. Now when I click OK and I run rules, notice what happened. Some mails got both the categories. Some mails got the red color and yellow color. How is that possible? Because remember what is happening when a mail comes, it is going to apply both rules. Both conditions are there. That means my name is there, but it's only name. Both conditions are true. So that's why it applied yellow and red. So now this is a very common mistake people do, and they get confused and they realize ki to no, Outlook rules don't work. Nah, Outlook rules work. The order matters, number one, and there's a very specific setting which most people have missed. It's not a new thing, but a very critical one. So let's go to order them. First rule will be if my name is the only name. Then if my name is in the to box, but still it is going to apply both rules. So I need to stop it at the first rule, if my name is the only name. So let's edit that rule and look at the action. What is the action? Apply color category. Now notice all the actions have checkboxes. What does that mean? You can have this and that, multiple actions. Now scroll down and you will see stop processing more rules. That's your best friend. So now when this rule is applied for that particular mail, further rules will be ignored. And now when you enable the rule, it will work as expected and you will not get duplicate colors. Stop processing more rules, understand it, then you can create more sophisticated rules. Now another scenario is, there is something I want to do where I want to apply to all mails. That means there is no condition at all. How do you do that? Well, create a new rule, and in the condition, don't select any checkbox. Just click next. Then it'll say, is this intentional? You have not selected any condition. That means you want to apply everything to all mails coming in. You say yes, and then whatever conditions you want, you manage. Simple. Another one. Very often, most people have kept the default pop-up which comes when a new mail comes. That's a notification which comes on the bottom right, and it keeps beeping and it keeps popping up. Now, many people keep it because they think, oh, if I remove it, then I will miss some mails. No, you're not going to miss mails. In fact, that's a distraction. Even if that pop-up comes, what if you are looking the other way? You're going to miss it anyway. So that's not a disaster. And even if you look at the pop-up, notice it, are you going to pounce on it and immediately answer? Most probably not. So please disable notification for all incoming mails. That will help you focus and concentrate. Now, of course, you're going to have a concern that no, important mails coming from boss, important customer, that I don't want to miss. For that, I want a pop-up. Fair enough. Now that is a different situation. First, disable all pop-ups. And for specific people you want pop-ups, sure, no problem. In fact, if it's a mail from boss and if it's a mail from an important customer, isn't that also high priority? Very good. So let's see how both are done. I'm going to create a rule. Let's create a rule for boss, for example. Now, if a mail comes from boss, so mail from, and then put the email ID of the boss. And what is the condition? I want to flag it as high priority. So use color category. Don't create another category. Category is high priority. We have already created it. This is also merging into that. So boss ka mail, also red color. Mail where my name is in the to box, also red color. Finally, important. Okay. And now I want a pop-up. Now you'll see action, action, action. Where is pop-up? Scroll down and you will see show a desktop notification. So now when a mail from boss comes, you have both. Now, of course, you can add more names as well and have multiple important people covered this way. So that's how you intelligently use rules to make your life easier. Now rules can run in one of the two places, on the desktop or on the cloud or browser or server. Now when you create a rule which has some condition or action which has to run on a desktop, then it will have a bracket which shows client only. Now, what does that mean? This rule is not going to run when your Outlook desktop is off. Remember that. Now, if you don't see client only, that means it will run irrespective of whether your Outlook is on or off. So notice that consciously. Now, the dialog which is there on the desktop is more sophisticated, but on the browser version of Outlook as well, we have a rules engine. It doesn't contain all the conditions and actions, but it is very usable. So if you use browser version, you can still use rules. And of course, because it's the browser version, all the rules created on the browser version 100% work on cloud side. So you don't have to keep Outlook open. Now there is an option of exporting and importing rules. There is an option of running rules on not just the inbox, but other folders. So explore the dialog and you'll understand the nuances of it. But whatever I have covered so far is good enough to get you started. And once you look at all the conditions and actions and think of what kind of work you do, you will be in a position to think of more scenarios about where rules can be effectively used in your case. If you get new ideas, do put it on comments. I would love to see how you are using this knowledge. So the last thing is out of office message. You know how to configure it when you're outside office. You go and say, from this date to that date, I'm going to be out. And during that period, whenever I get a mail, I'm not going to answer it. So I put a standard message. In fact, you can put two standard messages. One for people from inside the company, one from outside the company. So actually behind the scenes, this out of office assistant is actually an inbox rule and it is being applied to every incoming mail. So that's it as far as rules are concerned, but I've also created a very powerful and popular video for Outlook calendar best practices. Two videos, in fact. Have a look. If you like this, why don't you like, share, subscribe, and most importantly, try it out and let me know if it worked. So that's it for now. Thank you.